I am delighted to welcome Nazarene Youth International to Toronto for Youth Congress 99. Nothing gives me more pleasure than seeing young people come together to affirm their commitment to a better world. And no time is more fitting to make such a commitment than now in 1999. Les pages du calendrier s'envolent et le prochain millénaire approche rapidement. J'espère que ces prochains jours seront pour vous à la fois intéressants et enrichissants et que vous aurez la chance de goûter au charme et à la beauté de Toronto. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup.
So this week, you see, is not confined to here and now. This week is a part of what God is doing around the world, changing lives, transforming homes and schools and cities and nations. Jesus had 12. We had 150. Imagine what God is going to do with over 9,000 of us.
When we return home, God is more concerned with what happens after we leave than he is even with what happens here. The same God who meets with us here wants to rule our hearts and our lives when we return home 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Like a king without a country.
Moments, we're going to begin dismissing you by educational region to walk down Bremner Avenue to the Sky Dome, where we're going to have you in a picture in the outfield of the Blue Jays Stadium.
I know that God will work in our lives if we give our lives to him this week.
You'll get rid of the darkness. You'll let them know what it really looks like. And you'll invite them in to live in the reality of that kingdom. As we've been talking, this is what it means to be a global Christian.
In the paper, 9,000 teens on a mission.
They know what we stand for, so when we go outside these walls, let's show them and tell them what we stand for and make it straight and clear. All right, let's do it.
Jesus, tell what to take away your brain. Just watch for you to the market. In him, through him, for him, with him.
Radical Christianity is saying, I'm not into a religion. I am intimately into a relationship.
Opposite. If you give him your heart, if you surrender your life, if you come to him with a blank sheet of paper and say, Lord, this is my life, then and only then does he have the ability to shape and change your life.
Every move I make you do. You make me move.
What you have to say is, no matter what happens, I'm going to keep on keeping on. I'm going to get mine. I'm going to have my moment. It doesn't matter if I've got to preach to myself. It doesn't matter if I have to lay my own hands on my own head. It doesn't matter if I have to go outside of the cafeteria and preach a sermon just to me. I'm going to spend my time with Almighty God.
Help this week and on through the rest of this year, we are going to be establishing two church-based community youth programs around the world in two major cities.
Iniciar esse trabalho.
And that's why we need your help. We're starting a new computer center in Dona Marta to help those people, those teenagers that have no hope. And we need you. We need your help. We need your offering. We need your prayers so we can change those people's lives.
See, Jesus said, if you're going to go into the world and be salt and light, you have to go with integrity. You have to be people who live out the truth of the gospel, who live out the reality of this kingdom, the kingdom of the poor in spirit.
Give us clean hands, give us pure hearts, let us not lift our souls to another.
All right, it's time to give away some more satellite systems.
Trying to nail you, but so often people name the name of Christ and get fired up for Jesus, and so much of it sits on top of a layer of callousness and hardness because we refuse to come to the King with complete and total honesty.
May what we have heard and responded to from Brother Chap's message to us be as seed planted in good soil and bring forth a great harvest.
Traveling a highway and it's taking me to heaven.
Tell you that it's it's easy to hate your enemies. And it's just as easy to love your friends. Tell me how you're gonna live a life. While Mary and Martha just wanted to see their Lazarus. Oh, Lazarus, when will their Lazarus come forth?
And the number one quizzer for the NYC 99 Bible Quiz Tournament from the southeastern USA region, Adam Peterson. The number one team for NYC 99 from the southeast USA region, the Rebecca Nazarene College Regional Bible Quiz Team.
To your heavenly Father, a person who hears and answers. When you pray, make God the point of reference in your life.
You may not realize that, but there are a cloud of witnesses who are praying for you so that the Lord will touch you tonight, that the Lord may touch you during this week, so that you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you and you will be His witness.
Said, are you ready to serve? All right, come on, here we go. 1, 2.
Come, echo me. 2.
It's bigger than the air carrier. Shoes as a commitment to Christ to be His life. Okay? Take them. Amy's going to wear our symbol. But every one of us who are standing need to step into Jesus' shoes and make a difference in the world.
All the while God smiles down and I continue on my way.
All you have to do is stop saying, hey world, here I am, and start saying, hey God, here I am. At NYC, go out into the dark. Go out into the unknown. Go out into the God space. Go out there where you're inadequate. Go out there where it can't happen without God. Go out into the dark and put your hand in the hand of God
and it will be better unto thee than a light, and safer than a known way, and God will allow you to be a part of an adventure that will literally change this world.
Grass is green because
of
color.
When colors combine, they tend to form other colors. Grass is
green
when blue grass
and
yellow grass meet.
This plaque reads, Dr. Ponder Gilliland, thank you for dreaming the dream for Nazarene International Institute. The dream has become a youth movement. NYC 99, Toronto, Canada. Thank you, doctor.
You have a choice to make today. What will you do with your life? You're a treasure. Don't trash your life. Don't let Satan with his lies try to offer you what he has to offer. How much? Say no to Satan. Say no to all of that self-destructive life and just say yes to Jesus. Whatever you have for me, Jesus, that's what I want. Whatever you have for me. Are our future pastors, our future missionaries, our future evangelists. Put your hands together. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. I'll say yes.
You know it, and don't you be afraid.
And don't you be afraid.
You have to sing this to yourself sometimes. Joy comes in the morning.
Joy comes in the morning.
Troubles, they don't last always.
Troubles, they don't last always.
For there's a friend.
This is the body of Christ. Let us eat together. Let us partake together, symbolizing his death and his shed blood, so that we might have life, and that more abundantly. Let us share. Father, we are your...
Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing can bring me peace with God. Nothing can bring me peace with God. Nothing can bring me peace with God. You want to see Jesus in the light. You want to see. You want to see. You want to see Jesus.
15,000 teenagers from all over the world, members of the Church of the Nazarene, have descended on Toronto for their quadrennial World Congress.
We really live and do messed up things, you know, and I really think it's important that we're trying to change things, show people, you know, we really believe in what we stand for.
I think it's really important to show people, you know, that we do have God in our lives and that, you know, we're Christians and we're willing to stand up for what we believe in.
The Nazarene Youth Congress continues until Sunday. 9,000 young people having a good time and living out their faith. From the Convention Center, David Onley, City Pulse.
I wasn't ready.
Thing, looking at the boots and checking out to see what college I might go to.
Heard over and over and over this week is we can't do it alone. This is not a me thing. It's not about me. It's about Him working in me to give me the power to get out and do what I'm supposed to do for Him. We're not to miss our moment. We're to live in the God space. We're to be faithful to the very end.
It's what you are. It's what you want from me. Holiness, holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need. Holiness, holiness is what you want from
me. In a few moments, we'll leave this place. We want to leave changed.
It's what you want.
We want to leave pure. We want to leave with a sense of your smile on our face and your arm around us in fellowship and understanding the direction you're pointing us to, wherever that may take us.
Holiness is what I need.
Okay, I think I'm ready.
Clear!
As Christians, we're supposed to do stuff for other people and help them out, so that's what we're doing here.
Jesus went out of his way to help people, and that's, I think that's what we're doing.
not good. They're not good at all.
They use a shopping cart to haul their groceries here,
yeah.
And then they have no need for it afterwards. And so they just dump it in here because it's a lot easier than doing anything else with that.
It's good because it's a good united feeling about it. It's not a man, I'm so strong, I can get this out. It's, wow, we work together. We use our brains and our brawn to try to get things out and work everything together. So it's a lot of fun.
We are serving 300 hot dogs to the less fortunate people out here. I myself am kind of spoiled, staying in a big hotel, and this is real life.
They've been doing puppets and crafts and lots of singing. Kids just couldn't wait today for the group to come. And it's just really been exciting watching them interact with the children. They've just been wonderful.
Take your fingernail.
This is supposed to be a place of worship for some people later on, and that, you know, we're worshiping in the Air Canada Center, and they're worshiping in a gym, and anything we can do to make it better, that's like totally awesome.
I think it's life-changing, and we could like really make a difference in people's lives by coming down here.
I want to see the kingdom of God get bigger, and so that's my motivation.
And you are going to meet people later on in life that will probably say, thank you so much for what you did for me in 1999 in Toronto. And so we want to welcome you to Toronto, and we want to welcome you to MTO training. God bless you.
No. It wasn't exciting. It wasn't glamorous. It was an unseen and forgotten act. But you know what? I saw the work of God displayed there that night. Whatever you're going to be doing tomorrow, it's all about one thing. Taking